From amazing dinosaurs to Native American ruins, stay tuned to Number One to find out where millions of preserved fossils are still on view. Number 10, Blackwater Draw. Found in New Mexico near the town of Clovis, Blackwater Draw is one of the oldest archaeological sites in the U.S., with ancient artifacts upward of 12,000 years old being found there. To put that into perspective, that is around the time that mammoths roamed the land and arrows were the apex weaponry of the time. This area's claim to fame comes from the Paleoindians and the materials they would use. They had a unique type of projectile point called the Clovis point, made from a mixture of jasper, obsidian, and a few other types of brittle stone. Although these arrowheads were very brittle, they were unbelievably sharp. Discovering these allowed archaeologists to date the arrowheads as well as the other artifacts of that find. Over the years, more items have been found in the area, but the initial discovery of the Clovis arrowheads are still the biggest find in the region. Today, the area has been made into the museum where you can see the ancient weaponry and admire photos from their discovery. Number 9. Bighorn Medicine Well. This piece of history is rather interesting for two reasons. First, it was supposedly used by American Indians to read the stars. And second, because there are actually hundreds of medicine wells throughout the U.S. It is quite likely that if you live in the U.S., there is one relatively close to you right now. What makes the Bighorn Medicine Well in Lovell, Wyoming special is that it's the biggest one found to date, and it's also the most studied. That particular well has been dated between 300 and 800 years old. These structures got their names from their shape and their uncanny likeness to a wagon wheel. Each of these have a central cairn that is large enough to sit in and spokes leading to an outer circle, which also have a few cairns spread out throughout their circumference. If you sit in the middle and look down at another cairn on the wheel, it will lead you to a point on the horizon. Archaeoastronomer Jack Eddy has studied these and concluded that some of these point in the direction of the sunset and sunrise during the summer solstice, while others point towards significant star alignments. Number 8. Horseshoe Canyon. Located in beautiful southern Utah, Horseshoe Canyon is a great place to visit for two reasons. If you're a hiking enthusiast, it has an incredible 7-mile hike through the Canyonlands National Park. But more to the point, it also has some of the best examples of Native American cave drawings that you will ever find. This is especially impressive when you consider that some of the drawings are said to be among the oldest ever recorded, between 700 and 2,000 years old. The most famous point is known as the Great Gallery, and is over 200 feet wide and 15 feet high, featuring an array of life-size anthropomorphic images as large as 7 feet tall. To take the hike that will go past the drawings, you will need to begin at the Goblin Valley State Park and take the 30-mile drive up to the canyon before beginning your 7-mile round-trip hike, viewing not only the drawings, but all the nature that southern Utah has to offer. Number 7. Nash Dinosaur Track Site. If you want to walk where dinosaurs have walked, maybe even compare your foot size to that of beasts from millions of years ago, then luckily, we know just the place you should visit. The Nash Dinosaur Track Site is located in South Hadley, Massachusetts in the Connecticut River Valley area, and it's a great place to take your family to experience a piece of ancient history. The first tracks were found here back in 1802 by a farmer's son named Pliny Moody and were that of a small, long-extinct bird. Although they didn't know it at the time, that very fossilized footprint, as well as one other, would eventually make their way to Amherst College to be studied, bringing about the interest in the area and leading to the Nash Dinosaur Track Site being built in 1939, just 1 mile from the first footprint's discovery. If looking at tracks in the on-site museum and out in the surrounding areas of the park isn't awesome enough for you, you can always buy your very own dinosaur footprint or fossil at the on-site gift shop that is guaranteed to give your home that added classy edge that others just don't have. I need to know though, would you really own your own dinosaur track? Let us know in the comments below. Number 6. Crystal River Mounds. This archaeological site is labeled one of America's longest continually occupied sites. It is believed that the Native Americans would even travel hundreds of miles to this Floridian location to trade and bury their dead. During its busiest time of operation, it would see around 7,500 visitors a year. Covering 61 acres, the Crystal River Mounds contain multiple burial grounds where 1,200 people were buried, temple mounds that would be used to communicate with ancestors, a plaza area where the trading would take place, and something called a midden, which is basically a trash dump and found to contain all kinds of things from human waste right up to human bones. Today, the entire 61-acre site on the Gulf Coast of Florida has been labeled a National Historical Landmark with guided tours through the area, as well as a museum that houses some of the artifacts that have been found there. Number 5. Mystery Hill. When someone just mentions the name Salem, most minds automatically jump to Salem, Massachusetts and the witch trials of the 1690s. That is, everybody apart from those living in Salem, New Hampshire. This Salem is home to a place called Mystery Hill and is considered America's Stonehenge, containing a network of buildings that were first discovered in the 1930s, believed to have been built by the Native Americans of the time. Its construction started around 3,000 years ago and was still in use until around 200 years ago. Spanning 105 total acres, scientists are not too sure what the network of stone chambers was actually used for, but most hypothesize that it was a religious or spiritual center. Number 4. Blithe Intaglio. Native American drawings in caves and on walls are very popular throughout the U.S. However, the Mojave and the Quechan Indians have a different approach to this method of art and communication. These tribes chose not to even draw in caves, but right across entire landscapes. The best example of this is the Blithe Intaglio, just a few miles outside of Blythe, California. There are other world-famous geoglyphs in locations such as Peru, and over 300 of these landscape drawings exist in the American Southwest and surrounding regions. These drawings, though, are believed to be anywhere from 450 to 2,000 years old, and the artist would make the drawings by scraping the rock off the desert floor to expose the lighter soil below. The largest of these figures is around 170 feet, and, interestingly, are almost impossible to identify from the ground. As such, they weren't discovered until 1932 when a pilot flew over the area and happened to see them down on the ground below. What that does mean is you won't really be able to see these drawings unless you fly over them in a plane, but this creates a mystery as to how exactly the drawings were made from a strictly ground-level perspective. It must have been aliens. Okay, well, conspiracy theorists believe that it was aliens, but let us know your own theories on their creation below. While you're there, take a moment to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more Zero to Hero videos. Number 3. Mammoth Site. You probably already know that mammoths have been extinct for thousands of years. Luckily, in Hot Springs, South Dakota, you can visit a location that has the fossils of no less than 61 mammoths. Mammoth Site is quite accurately, if not unimaginatively named, because it contains the largest known concentration of mammoth fossils, including 58 North American Columbian mammoths and 3 woolly mammoths, all at the bottom of an ancient sinkhole that was around 65 feet deep and 150 feet wide and formed during the Pleistocene era. First discovered in 1974 when a construction worker found an unusual bone that was later recognized to actually be the tooth of a mammoth. The landowner at the time halted the construction and agreed to have the area investigated for more fossils. Jump ahead a few years and we now have the site that is today the home of a massive herd of mammoths. A museum has been erected in the area and visitors can see firsthand the mammoth fossils still embedded in the rock and sand that lies there. It is a fascinating site to visit and is definitely worth a family trip. Number 2. La Brea Tar Pits. If there is one location that deserves at least one visit in your life, it's this one. Located in Los Angeles, California, the La Brea Tar Pits are well worth your time. To date, around 3.5 million fossils have been found in the tar pits, with the oldest specimen found being a dire wolf dated around 44,000 years ago. What makes the tar pits so special is how well the asphalt preserved the fossils, and how it has preserved entire ecosystems of plants, bees, and other small insects. There was even the body of a 20-something-year-old woman found here. The tar pits themselves are blocked off to the public, but visitors of the park can watch real-life excavations in progress, as the excavation of fossils continues still even today. Only the fossils themselves can be seen for free, but you can always buy admission into the museum and take a look at some of the 1 million fossils that remain on the site. Number 1. Dinosaur Valley State Park. If there is one archaeological site that does it all, then Dinosaur Valley State Park near Glen Rose, Texas is definitely it. Not only does it offer you a day of hiking along trails where dinosaurs themselves walked, but it also offers many family activities, including horseback riding, hiking, and even geocaching if you're into that. Things got started for this park way back in 1908 when a massive flood washed through the area that the park now stands, revealing 3-toed tracks in the mud. Years later, a fossil collector saw the tracks in a shop in New Mexico and decided to research them a bit further. The result of this was the opening of the park in 1972, sealing off the 1,587-acre piece of land with the intention of preserving the tracks for future generations. Let us know what you think of these finds in the comments below, and take care!